Right, so I've been having a little bit of a hard time figuring out how to do the dispersion effect using the brush tool. So this is actually what my outcome was, and I kind of did my own method. I didn't use any of the YouTubers' methods to do this. So if I can remember, I literally just finished doing it. So what I'm going to try and do is open a new document. Or let me see. I'm gonna try and recreate what I literally just did. I want to see if I remember how I did it. So I'm just gonna open the PMG, the PM, PNG. Let me create a new document because it's acting crazy. And now I'm going to, let me try this one more time. I'm trying to open the transparent. Okay, it keeps coming back to here because this is where I have it open at. Okay. So, I wonder if it will let me add a layer. I'll try this one more time. I'm going to try to open this transparent image. Okay, since it's already open, it's not letting me do it. So I'm just going to place it. Okay, here we go. So I'm gonna place it. Now, I'll move him over using the move tool. So if I'm remembering correctly, what I first actually did was go to the eraser tool. I selected a brush that I thought would be good to kind of have him fading away with. I don't remember at all. All right, let me rasterize this because it's not going to let me edit anything. And I pretty much just started erasing him, right? Then what I did was go to filter, liquefy while it's already, as you can see, already having the eraser tool with a dispersion effect on it. And then I just, did what I had to do to liquefy the image, pulling it backwards. Okay. Now it's going to import this liquefied image into my layer. So I'm just waiting for it to do that. Okay. You know what I forgot to do is duplicate the layer, which I can just hit Control J now that I know that. So I'm gonna duplicate the layer. Now I'm gonna redo the liquefy. Right? See, I kind of messed up, so I'll go back in. So what would be good about this? I accidentally just did something that I noticed. Right around this area, I kind of don't have the dispersion effect of the brush there on the eraser tool set. And right around here, you can see it's just his natural shirt. Everything else kind of has the dispersion effect. So we'll pay attention to around this area when we do the next section. So, okay, we'll redo this process. Have it import. His eyeball is being stretched, as you can see. Okay. So we have this layer. And then we have this layer. Now, the top layer is what we're going to work with. I still have it on the eraser tool. And what I'm going to start doing is erasing. Now, as you can see, I like my method a little bit better. And I will show you why in a second. Let me just pick another brush tool. Let's make it a little bit bigger. Okay. There you go. Now, okay. I'm gonna say I like mine a little bit better, but now that I've applied this one, it's not so bad. I'm just playing around with brushes. I just literally had uploaded all of these, imported them. Okay, that took away a little bit too much with that brush. Just getting used to the brushes. I wonder if the brushes could be renamed. Oh, nice. Okay, you just right click or use two fingers to click on the mat to rename it. Okay, anyways, so I'm gonna leave it like this for now. Okay, and the top of the hat, I kind of don't like how that looks. Really quickly, I'm just gonna. There we go. Can't make it look like that. Alright, so anyways, it looks like he's fading away. Up here is kind of where the brush tool effect, the dispersion eraser tool, was already applied. Same thing down here, again, where I told myself to pay attention, which was in here. That's what was all t-shirt, so it's not bad. I kind of know how to do the effect now. So I'll probably look back at this video, see the steps that I took, and then, I don't know, kind of put it into steps just like I did the first video. With creating the self-illustrated logo. Some of these are actually pretty cool when you make them super big and just click here. If we go on this image and click, see, that's pretty cool. You can see the effect when it's kind of bigger. But I'm gonna take that effect off. Add it like that, and there you have it. In the first image, I did the same way with different brush tools, so that's that. How to add a dispersion effect using, really, a lot of these show on YouTube using the brush tool. I'm doing it using the eraser tool, so I don't know, because look, if I use a brush, here's the brush. They told me to select black on some of them. So let's open the new one. They told me to select black. This is what black does. I don't understand how you're using this, though, honestly. Okay, I kind of get it now. If you don't want it to be colored. I guess. A little bit smaller. Okay, I guess that doesn't look bad. It's using black. I'll undo those. And on the one, he said to use white. Okay. Let's choose a different brush. Make it a little smaller. I guess it really just depends on what you're going for. So with this light background or whatever color, you'd probably go with black. Maybe a little bit smaller, maybe. It's too small. Just kind of play with it until I get it where I want it to be. still kind of like my, and then that's the final for that one. Doesn't look bad. Not bad. Let's see if I can move them both a little bit smaller. So you can see what it looks like a little bit better. I guess it's not bad. So that's using the brush tool. And then this is using the eraser tool, which is just pretty much erasing the image. Now, I kind of do want to see how I had my last one compared to this. So what I'm going to do, I wonder if there's a way I could. Doesn't look like I could copy the layers. Yeah. Kind of want to remember what it looked like colored. Let's see if I can go back far enough. I don't think it's going to let me. Oh, here we go. And then this is what it had looked like. With colors still there. Oops. Step four. I'm trying to get off the hat. This is what it looked like with the colors still on there, with him kind of just fading away. So I'll probably look back at the video, maybe screenshot what it had looked like. There we go, so that's showing both of them. So here you can see it's with the brush tool, like a lot of YouTubers show you. Or you can just have it fading out using the eraser tool, which is right here. And then the brush tool, again, I'll put it back. Oops, step forward. The brush tool is right here. So click it, and it does the effect with whatever color you decide. I wonder how it looks if I choose the color that he's wearing. Yeah, that's how it looks. Alright, and that is about it. And so I want to use the eraser tool to erase some off top. Let's kind of come here and erase it off top, I guess. Doing anything at this point. Playing around with stuff. Dispersion Effect by Tanisha.